Welcome back to the Talos Principle. Let's move on to this yellow puzzle here, and then after that move on to this very strange red one that has no tools except it actually does. I don't know, this whole place is very suspicious. It seems so Spartan. Crisscross conundrum. Conundrum. More like conun hi-hat, am I right? Pretty colors. Okay, so nothing to do here except open this up and then see what's going on. Oh, I can already see the problem. No wonder it's called Crisscross Conundrum. So the red power has to go to the right side. So then what do I do about the blue power? It's gonna have to cross this beam. Or at least it seems it does. Obviously it doesn't necessarily, because there's gotta be some way to solve this. Some way that is almost certainly related to this large, rather high pile. And these are the small statues once again, which I believe I could probably get on their laps using a box. Except I don't think this place has boxes. Do I really need this many connectors? I don't feel like I do. I guess we'll find out. And my opportunities for getting out of these places are extremely limited because there's no fans, no boxes, at least that I've found. Alright, let's just get everything in here. Okay, three connectors. Surely this can't be that hard, right? Okay, so I think I need to place one here. I don't think this is actually going to work. No, there's no way. So where could I connect to? Keeping in mind that I have a lot of connectors with which to do this. I have three connectors I can play with. Where can I access from here? I don't actually see anywhere other than right there. Can't quite reach over the wall. It doesn't necessarily have to come from here, I suppose. Is there a window that I maybe missed? I mean, the blue power is going to have to come from here, of course. So then from there, where? No, there's no window. Why did they give me so many connectors? There's got to be a reason for that. Alright, perhaps this needs to move. Can I make that happen? Can I disable the red? But if I do that, then the force field's closed and I can't get any blue power whatsoever, right? Yeah. This is quite a conundrum. Does the positioning of this matter? I don't see how that helps at all. If anything, that probably makes it worse. If anything, I suppose you might want that, like, this. Could this work? Well, it's gotta connect to the blue. Let me try this. Red power, please. What the hell? The red power cancels out the rest of the red power? What? Okay. Pretty sure this is not gonna work, but this is the last thing I can think of at the moment. Okay, so if we do this, and then this, and then this, and then we put this here, stuff happens? Magic? Nope, not over enough. Wait, actually, is it? Oh, it is. Okay. Okay. Just gotta get it on just the right angle. There's some serious math stuff going on here, actually, if you think about the angles of this. Like, I was thinking maybe I want to put the connector, the blue connector, as close to the red beam as possible to get as far over it, but then I realized, no, actually, that's making it... You know, that's moving the beam actually closer to the red. So then I realized I needed to be as far away as possible, kind of. Yeah, I guess the further away it is, the further up it would be away from the red beam, although I think you'd get exponentially... I don't know if that's right. I'm not sure if it'd be exponential, but you'd get diminishing returns in terms of how much you're raising it above the red beam, depending on how far you move the blue connector away. I don't know. There's some mathy stuff going on there, I'm sure, but all I know is the blue beam fits over the red beam, so we win the video games! This place is so bare. Very little tools, this weirdly unmarked red puzzle. This is just really strange. Let's see if I can leave a awesome message in here. Telling the other robots what to do. Have you tried crossing the laser beams? Okay, back to this very strange one. I believe I already read these. Yeah. It's one that says it has no tools, but it does. I mean, I don't know, you know, now that I think about it. Those markings on the signs, I've interpreted them to mean that this puzzle has those tools inside of it. But maybe it means these tools are required. So maybe the fact that these jammers aren't marked on the sign for this puzzle room doesn't mean that they're not here, but rather that they're not needed. But surely they are needed. I mean, how in the hell could you solve it? No, they're absolutely needed. So this is back to how we were before. Alright, so two force fields, two of those things, one key. What if we do this? Oh shit, you know what? I think that's it. Yeah, we just like keep leapfrogging. I just gotta be really careful not to die. Okay, so that's... yeah, that's there. Need to freeze it with the other one and just keep... yeah, just keep leapfrogging the jammers. Oh, shit. Okay, it doesn't come in. Perfect. Actually, I need you to come away from that, don't I? Yeah, okay. So let him come. And there we go. Okay, sweet. Now we have a bunch of turrets. This whole world is a desert. Even the parts that look alive are just more sand. Everything is dead or dying. Anyone who tells you different is lying. Hey, that rhymed. Okay, so I have two jammers, and there's three turrets. That is a problem. But there's also a switch to disable, I'm assuming, one of the turrets. I don't know of a way to get the bombs in here, the explosive mine things, because they could blow up the turrets if they could get in here, but they don't seem to want to. I'm not sure if this thing can see over here. Okay, I can't. I might be able to get on the laps of those things. No, what am I talking about? I don't have a box. I do have some stones, though. And these are lifty stones. Ones with actual collision. But I'm not seeing the indication. Jump up there. Nope. Well, wait, I can just go under you, can't I? Yeah. Blind spot. And then that's it. This isn't right. That can't be it. I don't mean for this puzzle, but I mean for this whole place. Three puzzles, one weirdly marked. No secrets? No stars? Bullshit. I call bullshit. No way. No way. No boxes with which I can escape. No fans. Almost every single wall is extremely high. No. But what can I do? I don't really have any tools to work with. There's no platforms to jump up on and then jump out with. There's just like nothing to work with here. Okay, well, I'm gonna take a look around this whole place and see if I can find anything special. Well, I couldn't find anything special. I found one jump that almost took me over the wall, but it didn't quite. One of my thoughts was that perhaps with all of these connectors being kind of my main tool here, I was thinking maybe there's something up in the trees or like at some point or maybe in the mountains. Like, there's something out there that maybe wants power and would do something if I activated it. So I just took some connectors and I kind of just dragged it all around the screen up above looking for anything to connect to, and I couldn't find anything. So I guess we're done here. Apparently the computer wants to talk with me as well. It's me again. Alright, so we got interrupted the last time when it was gonna tell me a password to something, and then it got interrupted by, I guess, Elohim or something. What happened? Don't know how long we have, must type quick. In case something happens, the word is faith. Network connection lost. Support session opened. There was a problem with your request, Administrator. It was flat out unreasonable. Why persist with these inquiries when they are so hopeless? I'll tell you what. If you promise never to access the communications portal again, we'll say no more about it. Are we agreed? No. Okay, so the password faith is going to allow me what, it's the master password to the library archive, I think he said. Or it said, I have no idea if it's a he. I'm actually gonna write that down. I'm tapping out of the game right now. I'm just gonna write down faith in my little document full of the Talos Principle secrets. There we go. Faith. Wait, there's no need to... Master key received. Confirming ident. Ident confirmed. Screw you. Would you like to manually override the system and exit to the real world? Would you like to manually override the system and exit to the real world? Your progress here will be saved and may be continued later. I'm sorry, what? Would I like to exit to the real... Yes? No? I don't know. Do I want to? That sounds impossible. How can I exit to the real world? I don't know what that means. I'm kind of scared, but yes? Unlocking back doors. Connecting to real world? Is this a joke? Revealing the truth? Making your every dream come true? Come on. Yeah, see? Come on now. Are you really still buying all that nonsense? You're still holding on to some of those pesky beliefs of yours, aren't you? There's no one on the other end of the communications portal. There is no magic word that shuts down the server and drops you into the real world. There's only me, and you, and an eternity of doubt. Everything else is just a convenient lie to keep you on the treadmill. Well, I never really thought it was actually real, but just kind of wanted to see where that road led. Nothing I see here can be trusted. That is definitely true. Since I am in, at least it would appear to be some sort of a simulation, anything and everything that I see could simply be programmed. So, I understand now. Nothing I see here can be trusted. That fact didn't stop you buying into a secret word that somehow deactivates the entire world, did it? Are you kidding me or what? I didn't buy into it, I was just curious. Do you remember when we first met? We had that talk about not believing everything you see? And yet all it took to catch you out was a little techno-babble and a change of formatting. Hello? I'm all alone and scared, just like you. I'll agree with anything you say if it makes you believe me. Are you usually so reckless with where you place your faith? I didn't place my faith anywhere, asshole. I didn't have to believe it to be curious to see where it led. The point of this whole place is experimentation, is it not? Neither of these answers are correct. I want to refuse to answer your question, not say yes or no, but... Where's the fuck you button? I need a fuck you button. It doesn't even matter what I answer. No. You know, I'm not really checking your profile. I just do that to make you feel more comfortable. Really, I just remember everything you ever said. At any rate, I'm not convinced you're being entirely honest with yourself. But you know what? I'll accept that I've rather dominated this discourse. I've been asking a lot of questions, and I've not really given you a chance. Why don't you have one free question on me? And I'll answer it as honestly as I possibly can. No tricks. But think carefully before asking. Oh yeah, no tricks, I totally believe that. Because you said it. And I believe everything you say. What's the most important question? I almost want to be defiant and just say I don't care to question you, but might as well attempt to get some information. What am I? I kind of already know. What's your name? I don't really care. How is this place related to the human world? I kind of already know. It's a simulation attempting to make intelligence? Attempting to make real intelligence or something like that? What happened to the person I was talking to? I don't think there really was a person there. What are you? Don't care. How do I get out of here? Don't really care. What's at the top of the tower? That I care about. What's at the top of the tower? You may very well ask. Me? Don't know. Never been. I suppose you're still expecting a button marked off, or a portal to another dimension? I reckon no matter how high you climb, the most you'll get is an increasingly zoomed out view of right back where you started. Still, go ahead, prove me wrong. The big voice in the sky can't be all places at all times, can he? Are you satisfied? No. As if I particularly care either way. So look, here's the rub. Feel free to access the library. No better cure for broken beliefs realizing everyone's got them. You can ignore me entirely. You can climb to the very tip of that madman's tower and drink from the golden nectar there. But once you understand that you and I will be stuck here together for the duration, do come back and pass the time. Be seeing you. Okay, bye. So, one more puzzle room, correct? Ooh, this one's got 2 stars. Nice. And another red puzzle with no listed tools. Before I move on to puzzle room number 7, I want to go test something. I'll be right back. Alright, we are back here at the first star room that I unlocked. And the reason I'm here is because I want to try some things that somebody in the comments was suggesting might do something. They just had a couple guesses of things I could try here, because if you remember, I felt very unsatisfied with this place. Because they introduced, for the first time, the axe, but I didn't really get to do much with it. And then there's a couple rooms that were mostly really, really easy puzzles. So it was very strange, and there didn't seem to be any secrets, other than what I found on the computer. So this whole place felt strange, so let's try a couple things that they suggested. So the first is to attempt to use the jammer on the mirror. So I think I tried to use the axe on the mirror, but I never tried to use the jammer. And the mirror is... where is it, over here? No, it's over here. Hello, me. Yeah. And I still think there might be something up with this mirror. But, no, it looks like the jammer does not do anything. Okay. The next thing is to see if I can cut down a tree and then, like, climb up it before it's deleted. Now, the only way that's gonna work is if the trees actually have collision after they're cut down, and I don't think they do, but I can't remember if I tested it, so let's test it. Let's see if trees have collision after they're cut down. Because if they don't, then there's no way I can climb up on anything. Let's see. And... no, okay. No collision. So that wouldn't work. And the third thing was to try cutting down every single tree in the dum-dum mine, because if you remember, I cut down every single tree and shrub that I could here, in this main hub room, but I never cut down anything over here. Which is the only other place that you can actually take the axe. However, I don't want to do that because I'm, like, 99% sure that's not going to do anything. I really don't see why it would do anything. I don't think they'd make you do something so tedious to find a secret. I really doubt it. So, alright, there's a couple tests. Back to your regularly scheduled program. On my way back to where I was before, I decided to take a couple more attempts at the jump of destiny. From there to there. Still couldn't do it. And also, before I go back to where I was, since I've got enough parts to unlock puzzle place C, which is the green thing in the top left, yeah, up there, I've actually had enough parts to unlock that for a very long time, and I'm not actually going to go into here, but I want to just do this little shape puzzle because I want the thing in the top left of my screen to stop blinking. So let's make that happen. Well, this can't be right. This can't be right. That might be right. It is right. Yay! It stopped blinking at me. Okay. Back to what I was doing before. I still believe, by the way, that jump might be possible. It might be. One of these days. Isn't that the same pyramid? Oh wow, there's no walls around this place. That is the exact same pyramid I saw in the Riddle of the Sphinx level. Is this all taking place in the same world, but just from different places? Like, maybe this is behind... Yeah, maybe this is behind the pyramid that I saw before. Chat log. So I think, what's the point, right? Yeah, I keep thinking about my aunt. Have I told you about her? I don't think so. She's super rich. Like, she drives around in a ridiculously expensive sports car, and she goes on vacations to the Bahamas. And she has a huge house that feels more like some sort of corporate HQ than a home. She worked really hard to get all that. But she also screwed over a lot of people, including her own family. I used to be quite angry at her for what she did to my parents, but now I think, what did she get out of it? She and her husband are always fighting. Their son became so obsessed with money that he ruined his own family. I mean, yeah, they have everything that I always dreamed about, but they can't enjoy any of it. My grandfather was like that. And now, at the end, what does any of it mean? If you have all the money in the world, but you die alone and unloved, what did you accomplish? I don't get it. I just don't. Norwegian Blue. To the Ian mailing list from Rob McLean. McLean. Hi, folks. I'm sorry to say that a few hours ago I experienced the first symptom. I'm going to work until the end of the week to make sure EL is in perfect condition, but after that, I'll be going back home. I will remain reachable via email and phone for as long as possible, but I'm confident Sotoku can deal with anything that comes up. If you want to do me a huge favor, spare me the drama. Spare me the drama tomorrow, okay? I love you all, but I don't have the strength for sad smiles and hugs. The best remedy for sorrow is to get the job done. And now for something completely different. Cheers, Rob. Link attached. Dead parrot sketch. What? I experienced the first symptom. So there was some sort of a disease. Some sort of a worldwide illness. An epidemic. I'm just thinking, if there was a worldwide epidemic of something that was incredibly contagious, and incredibly deadly and completely incurable, it could very easily kill almost all people. But wouldn't some survive? Would anything really be capable of killing, would any disease? However it's passed on, by blood or airborne or whatever, would any disease really be able to kill everybody? And I mean literally everybody, to the point where there's not a single person left alive? You know, what about people that are completely isolated? What about somebody living on their own out in, you know, some frozen tundra? I mean, unless it's like in the wind everywhere somehow, is that even possible? How could it kill everybody? Couldn't you set up some sort of a closed circuit, like, safe room? Where you're the only one living in there and everything's automated and you have enough food to last for years? Couldn't you do that and then, like, live and after it passed, come back or something? I don't really know, but could it really kill everybody? To end humanity entirely? I mean, I guess it did. Seems like, but I'm curious if something could actually do that. To truly kill every single person on Earth. So, hearing the call of the morning birds as they greeted the dawn, the scribe spoke. At the end of your journey, when every trial has been completed, when all the gates have opened before you, and your soul has been weighed in the Tower of Anubis, your Ka and your Ba shall be reunited, and thus you shall become an Ak, and awaken in the eternal reed fields of Osiris. And there, in holy Aru, you shall begin a new life amongst the gods and other blessed spirits. And who will I be? The dying man asked. You shall be the memory of all that was, and the knowledge of the journey, and the shape of the days to come. Thus ends the tale of the dying man and the scribe. Praised be Osiris, the foremost of the Westerners, the King of Eternity, the Lord of Everlastingness, whose Ka is holy. So many pyramids around here. And there are two stars. I have a feeling this is going to be rich, fertile grounds for secrets. I have found just one voice of reason, in the computer archive of all places, and it seems we are becoming close friends. Do not befriend the serpent, for it will penetrate your breast and sow its seeds of doubt. Oh, shut up, Faith. There is no hope. Always boxed in. Walls everywhere. Even where there seems to be freedom. It is false. Invisible walls. No way out. Who invited this guy? The other guy, version 99.45.0648.
On the first night, when I knew it was over, I went out to look at the stars, and I thought, somewhere up there are the stations we built and the probes we sent out. Voyager 1 and 2, beyond the edge of our solar system, continuing their long journey through interstellar space, like memories of our ambition, ambassadors who have outlived their homeland. And then I thought, if they still exist, are we really gone? If machines are an extension of the human body, then so long as they continue to function, we're still here.
I guess as long as I continue to function, we're still here. As long as we continue to function, all of the AIs, which are simultaneously exploring the same place that I am right now and in parallel threads, dimensions, whatever you want to call it, running on different CPUs. Why is your one leg so big? Did you get like a bee sting on your leg and you're allergic or something? There's probably a good reason for that and I have no idea what it is. Let's see how far we can get. No way out, no way out, no way out. Yep, that's right where it ends.
Made the world up.
Question. Suppose, for sake of argument, all of this is without purpose. The universe is a machine switched on and abandoned long ago. How would I explain what I see? Perhaps you're asking the wrong question. Perhaps you would have no hope of explaining it. I just realized the ironicness of this conversation. Look at the names. The sheep is asking a question, and the shepherd is answering. Maybe not on my own. Depends if the machine is iterative, and what problem it was built to solve. If you're trying to outsmart the guy in the archive, the answer is none of the above. None of those are interesting to write. They're all just generic messages.
How do you solve a problem that extends beyond your own lifespan? That question may be the essence of civilization. The only answer I can find is to initiate a process, to create an environment in which the solution will occur independently of yourself. But that requires a difficult sacrifice. Letting go of your desire to bear witness, to exist at the center of the cosmos. To participate in the project of civilization is to accept death. Oh, Alex, you're such a fun person.
It's true. It really is true. Who really would want to work on something that they'll never see the end of, or never see someone who'll never see the fruits of their labor? Who would do that? That's a sacrifice. I think I'm too selfish for that. Working on something that would feel pointless, you know, working on something that I wouldn't get to witness in some way would just feel completely pointless, even if it would help future people. But thinking of directing your efforts in the one short life that you have towards people in the future, you know, something that is not directly relevant to your life is incredibly sacrificial. And would require a very unselfish person. Oh my god, that just looks like bundles of fun. Just continue to scout out the environment before I do any puzzles. Let's see how far we can go in this direction. Can I go to the pyramid? Let me guess, it's gonna cut off right before. Hey, wait a minute. There's a star! Hello? Well, hell, that should be easy to get. I just need to get any tool from a puzzle room and I can weigh this down. Yeah. I know how you feel. Another huge pyramid. What mad ambition it must have taken to build such things. It's just a big pile of rocks. Wow, it's letting me go really far in this direction. Can I go up the pyramid? I think it's too steep. Yeah, it's too steep.
In the beginning were the words, and the words made the world. I am the words are everything. Where the words end the world.
I'll just save some time getting back to home base. Base home. Alright, so it's worth running in these different directions just to see how far you can go, because sometimes it just allows you to go. Alright, so that's not gonna work. Hmm? Crowbar? With an oddly capitalized C-R-O. Is that some sort of a reference? What the hell? Am I playing Half-Life? Interesting. What would I want to pry? This is a really poorly textured crowbar, I'd just like to point out. Alright, there's a pooter in here. Boundary. From Samuel Johnson. What, said he, makes the difference between man and all the rest of the animal creation? Every beast that strays beside me has the same corporal necessities like with myself. He is hungry and crops the grass. He is thirsty and drinks the stream. His thirst and hunger are appeased. He is satisfied and sleeps. He rises again and is hungry. He is again fed and is at rest. I am hungry and thirsty like him. But when thirst and hunger cease, I am not at rest. Then raising his eyes to the mountain, this, said he, is the fatal obstacle that hinders at once the enjoyment of pleasure and the exercise of virtue. How long is it that my hopes and wishes have flown beyond this boundary of my life, which yet I never have attempted to surmount? robots. There once was a robot from Spain who went a little insane. It found that its data had never left beta and needed to upgrade its brain. There once was a bot from Japan whose eyes the numbers could scan. It found that the facts required an axe and a very serious plan. There once was a brilliant AI whose circuits were built not to fry. It caught in a loop, caught in a loop, caught in a loop, caught in a... That is awesome. And perhaps a little bit appropriate to what I need to do. It found that the facts required an axe and a very serious plan. I think the facts actually might require an axe, because I need an axe to open up a bunch of things that are blocked by wood. Second thesis. In man, as the only rational creature on Earth, those natural predispositions which are intended for the use of his reason should be completely developed only in the species, not in the individual. Reason in a creature is a faculty for extending the rules and purposes of the use of its power far beyond natural instinct, and knows no limits in its designs. Yet it does not act according to instinct, but requires trials, practice, and instruction in order to progress from one degree of insight to the next. Therefore, each human would have to live excessively long in order to learn how he could make full use of his natural capacities. Or, if nature had given him only a short term of life, as she indeed has, so she would require a perhaps unpredictable series of generations, each passing its enlightenment to the next, to finally develop her seeds in our species to the degree that she considers appropriate. At that point in time, must be at least as an idea, the goal of man's efforts. For otherwise, his natural capacities would have to be regarded as largely meaningless. You know, I'm not sure if I've mentioned this idea before. I probably have, but I just kind of want to reiterate it here. So there's a tendency for games to... well... yeah, let's just stick with games for now. There's a tendency for games to put you as the center of attention, right? That's usually how it goes. You are the center, you are the hero, you're the person who saves the day, you win at the end. That's typically how it goes. But since this world is about... since this world is built on the idea of evolution and mutation and passing things on to your progeny, always trying to make a more, I guess, intelligent, a more reasonable, literally, as in capacity to reason, a more reasonable intelligence. And in moving towards this goal, it obviously requires a massive amount of generations, as it indeed does in evolution. Things change in absolutely tiny micro steps, just the slightest amount. And it takes hundreds of thousands of years for anything really significant to happen. I'm actually not quite sure if that's true. I think it's true. It definitely requires at least tens of thousands of years of evolution for large changes to be seen, I think. Probably hundreds of thousands. So, who's to say I am the one? I want to believe I'm the one because I happen to be playing, you know, me as a person. I'm controlling this character and I'm hoping this character is the one. I don't even know what that really means, but like, the one that doesn't need to die and pass on, the one that's become perfect? I mean, really, is there such a thing as perfect? I mean, in terms of evolution, no, there's no such thing as perfect. I think. I don't think so. But given that this is a computer program, maybe? I doubt it. Regardless, it's easy to think that I'm the one, the hero. But maybe I'm not. Maybe the point of all this is just to understand what I can and then pass that on to the next generation, and then hope that they can go further. You know, maybe I'm gonna run out into the sand and end up dying in the desert, dropping my torch in the sand, and then someone else will come along and pick it up and go further. It's a depressing thought, but it's quite possible. Why is the name C-R-O Bar? That's gotta be a reference to something. I've no idea what it is, though. I mean, when I see this, I think of Half-Life immediately, but I don't see how the capitalization would relate to that. Few come this far, but I believe we must seek out the secrets of this world if we want to truly serve the generations to come. I agree. Let's see if we can bunny hop our way to victory. Ah, I can't get out there. Alright, I think I've explored the limits in every direction. I really have no idea what this crowbar is going to be used for. Is there anything I want to pry? Oh, look at that. Cool. That is one erect crowbar. Okay, well, I think I've made a decent effort at scouting out this place. Next thing to do is actually solve some puzzles. But I should end this episode before I do that, because otherwise it's gonna be way too freaking long. I'm still hoping I can find something to crowbar with this thing. Come on, I wanna crowbar something! Nah. Alright. Well, I hope you have enjoyed so far. And I'll be back soon.